we are discussing about the transmission medium. The transmission medium can be classified either guided or unguided. Guided transmission medium can be further classified by twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic. An unguided medium can be classified by microwave, infrared wave, and others. We have already discussed about the twisted pair, its advantages, its disadvantages, its application, and so on and so forth, as well as coaxial cable, fiber optic. The major concern of our topic is with respect to unguided media. Unguided media, as we know that it is concerned with microwave, infrared waves, and other waves. In other waves, we can count it as X-rays, radio waves, and etc. So further, this slide predicts the electromagnetic spectrum. In electromagnetic spectrum, we are having frequency from 0 to megahertz, gigahertz, terahertz, and pentahertz. On each frequency band, there is a different type of application. For example, twisted pair, coaxial cable, AM radio, FM radio, terrestrial and satellite transmission, microwave, radars, infrared waves, X-rays, and so on and so forth. So this is the whole soul electromagnetic spectrum for the communication of unguided media and guided media. Okay? Certain applications work on certain frequencies, other applications on other frequencies, and so on and so forth. We have already discussed this electromagnetic spectrum. So this is a little bit recap about the electromagnetic spectrum. Now this is the problem with violin. As you are seeing this picture, it is very difficult to manage the cables. To manage the cables, it's a complete different job. It required times, and it required professional skills. To overcome from this problem, we have a solution which is called wireless LAN. Now we will have our introduction with wireless LAN. As I have already discussed with you, there is a standard which is called 802.11. It is the IEEE standard, which is well known as Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi commonly we use as a WLAN. This technology is the alternative for wired. The benefits of this technology is you don't need highly skills to establish the LAN. You don't need wires. You can manage within a short of time, and you can also provide some sort of mobility. So while moving, you can have a browsing on your laptop, on your cell phone, and on your any other device that can be connected via wireless. Wi-Fi is also known with this wireless fidelity. It is a generic term that refers to the IEEE, as I have already discussed with you, at 802.11 communication standards. Wi-Fi networks connects computers to each other and internet to wire network. Now, this wireless technology is the main provision for the easiness in the life. Via this technology, we can expand or we can deploy our network, our local area network, within a short of time. How Wi-Fi works? The working mechanism of Wi-Fi, we can predict by this picture. In this picture, as you are seeing, there are multiple types of hardware. The central one, that is called AP, which is called access point. Access point, it is basically a hardware that provides a Wi-Fi interface, a Wi-Fi atmosphere. And this device can connect up to 30 more devices using wireless LAN. This device can provide the services, for example, internet via backbone, as you are seeing in the picture. The cloud predicts as an internet. And internet is coming via a DSL or ADSL modem, and this modem is terminated in access point. So this access point is further responsible for distribution of this internet to the wireless devices. Now wireless devices can be your LCD, can be your workstation, can be your laptop, and can be your PDA. The most notable thing in this is the each device can be on the same network. When I am talking about the same network, then the meaning of this is the IP should be same. Matlab IP first host, first octet, second octet, or last octet. If it is class C IP, then the three octets must be same. The last octet will be changed. So we call it is on the same network. So this is the working mechanism of Wi-Fi. Now Wi-Fi can be connected via a certain methods which are called topologies. So there are three types of Wi-Fi topologies. One of which is XP based, or we can say infrastructure mode. Second one is ad hoc mode, and third one is point to multipoint. We will discuss each topology one by one. AP based technology. AP based technology is nothing but it is a combination of access points, backbones, backhauls, and wireless devices itself. For example, in wireless devices, we can count wireless router and a device that is that want to acquire the services from that access point. As you are seeing, there are two access points in this picture. They are connected via backhaul. This backhaul can be a guided medium, and we have already discussed guided medium can be coaxial cable, or it can be Ethernet cable, or it can be fiber cable. Then the service provided to these both devices is via internet or via backhaul. In this scenario, the backhaul is provided by switch, then router, and then cloud. And cloud is basically for what? Internet. So this is the mechanism for AP-based technology. Each AP-based technology has its own range. For example, the maximum range line of sight, free line of sight, our access point can provide it is up to 300 meters. For each device can be can cover the 300 meters, and if we want to extend this version, then we will have another access point. So by this we can extend our networks. For example, as far as this university is concerned, we have two access points on our CS department, two to three access points on our main building, and one to two access points on our outdoor area. So these access points basically provide a campus Wi-Fi facility. So this facility is based on AP based technology, which is access point based technology. After that, there is another technology, topology, which is called ad hoc based. Now ad hoc based technology is nothing but each node can be behave itself as an AP. For example, in this mode, there are four laptops or four workstations. They are connected with each other by a link, one of which is behaving as a server, and three of which is behaving client. If some sort of reason this server is disconnected, the server responsibility of the network will be adopted by another devices. So this type of applications or this type of network mostly used in military purpose. For example, drones, MBT, manned battle tanks, and so on and so forth. So this is ad hoc based mode. Another mode which is called point to multipoint. Now point to multipoint mode, in which there is a central device. This device is responsible to provide the services to the rest of the nodes. For example, a central device can be placed on the tower, and with tower, certain locations like this building, these homes, and so on and so forth, where we can provide the services of Wi-Fi. So this is we call point to multipoint topology. Now flavors of Wi-Fi. There are basically three flavors of Wi-Fi. One is 802.11b, 802.11a, 802.11g. They are differ with each other with respect to certain parameters. We will discuss one by one parameters. For example, 802.11b. The most popular standard currently in deployed. This standard is basically currently in use. This standard is working on 2.4 gigahertz. 2.4 gigahertz is a frequency. Okay. And this frequency comes under ISM band. Now, what is ISM band? ISM band is an industrial, scientific and medical band. It's a free worldwide. In every part of world, you can use this band, and then there will be no charges for you. Okay? So mostly our Wi-Fi devices, which are we are using in our houses, are working on 2.4 and so on and so forth, like these type of band. The second flavor is 802.11a. It operates the 5 gigahertz unlicensed national information infrastructure band. Again, it is the unlicensed infrastructure band. It can vary. The range of this band can be vary country to country. And the devices which are working on this band is 5 gigahertz. 5 gigahertz basically the frequency on which these devices are working. But the problem with this band, this flavor is it is not compatible with previous one. Previous one was 802.11b, and 802.11a is not compatible with 802.11b due to differences in frequencies. The data rate of this flavor is 54 Mbps. Means you can transmit 54 Mbps. That is again depend upon the physical environment or unguided media environment. As we discussed that in B we can send up to 11 Mbps, and in A we can send up to 54 Mbps, and G we can send up to 54 Mbps. The frequency on which G flavor is working is 2.4 gigahertz, but the capability of this flavor is it is compatible with 802.11b. Now here, what do you mean by compatible? Compatible means if you have one device which is working on 802.11b, another device which is working on 802.11g, now both can work with each other and both can transmit, both can pass the data via backhaul. This is so called compatibility. Okay. Now the wireless LAN applications. Basically the wireless LAN applications, mostly as you know that environment point of view, it is used in homes, enterprises, small offices, outdoor campus, hospitals, car and large vehicles and factories. If you want to compile the patient's record or on ECG machine, an ECG machine can be connected via wireless network, then these parameters can be recorded on a central server, then we can doctor can jo compile the proper diagnosis and proper monitoring of the patient. Okay, what about the small offices? Yes, what type of applications?
To save the record of employees.
Okay. Basically, it's a LAN. It's a LAN. The difference between this LAN and wire LAN is the medium. Here we use the medium is wireless. And in wire LAN, we use the medium wired. So there are major applications in offices. For example, if the employee wants to connect its PDA, its laptop rapidly with the servers and to get the prints and so on and so forth, multiple types of application that can be used in home and offices. Physical layer. So as far as physical layers is concerned, on physical layers, the physical layer, it is a first most layer of the OS reference model. This layer is responsible for all the movement of the bits, okay, and the signaling. Can anybody let me know how many types of signaling are over here? Digital and analog signaling, okay. And digital and analog signaling, what do you mean by digital signal? Digital signal is a discrete signal which covers sequence of bits, and it can be it can have only two states, either 0 or 1. What about the analog signal? continuous. It can vary with respect to amplitude, with respect to time, okay, with respect to voltage. Okay. So digital signals and analog signals, basically these two signals are concerned on physical layer. On physical layer, there is a conversation between these signals, which is called analog to analog conversation, analog to digital conversation, and digital to digital conversation. Okay. There is a concept of PCM, pulse code modulation. What do you mean by this? Do you have any idea about pulse code modulation? Digital, analog to digital, analog to digital, or digital to analog conversation. How pulse code modulation works? Yes, anybody? We have discussed already in last lectures.
In this scenario, the amplitude remains constant at the time changes.
Pulse code modulation basically works on three stages, one of which is sampling, quantization, and guarding. Now, what is sampling? To set the values of amplitude, okay? And what about the quantization?
Sir, it measures the maximum and minimum amplitude.
Yes, measures the maximum and maximum and minimum amplitude values, okay? And the samplings, basically it creates a sample. Our sample can be uniform and non-uniform, okay? And what about the coding? Converting that value of amplitude from analog to digital. This process can be achieved by a binary conversation, binary digital to binary conversation. Okay. So as far as we discussed physical layer, we discussed digital signal, analog signal, and we also discussed about the conversation of analog to analog conversation and analog to digital conversation. Now. As far as medium is concerned, we have also discussed the guided medium and unguided medium. In unguided medium, we have discussed the microwaves. We have discussed the radio waves. Microwaves, can you let me know the applications of the microwave? For example, this mobile. On which type of wave this mobile is using? Yes. Microwave. Radio wave, and frequency, infrared wave. Which type of frequency this mobile is using?
Microwave.
Okay. What about the FM radio?
Radio
wave. What about AM radio?
Frequency.
Okay. And what about the this laser light?
Laser.
Okay. So, as far as concerned with the medium, guided medium and unguided medium, so microwave and radio wave. Microwave has a versatile of lots of applications. As far as concerned is cellular networks, satellite networks, point-to-point communication and point-to-point multi-communication. You all 2G, 3G and 4G, all these networks are working on microwave, okay? So Wi-Fi is also a technology that works on microwave. Okay, the frequency on which Wi-Fi can work is 4 gigahertz to 5 gigahertz. For example, your devices, less like Cisco Wi-Fi device and Alcatel Wi-Fi device, TP-Link Wi-Fi device, these all devices are working on certain frequency which is comes under ISM band, and ISM band it is what? It is nothing but industrial, medical and scientific band. It is available worldwide. Wi-Fi, basically the working mechanism of Wi-Fi, a Wi-Fi spot is created by installing an access point to an internet connection. An access point can act as a base station. When Wi-Fi enabled device encounter the hotspot, the device can be connected to that network wirelessly. For example, if this mobile is receiving internet from the 2G and 3G, by the help of hotspot software, I can make this mobile as a Wi-Fi hotspot, okay? Wi-Fi access point. And the rest of wireless device can connect it to this mobile via this access point. So the working mechanism behind the Wi-Fi is that we should have an access point, we should have a backbone, and we should have a device that can be connected to the access point. So today our topic is wireless LAN. The outline for this topic is a little recap of OSI reference model, transmission medium, wireless LAN, wireless LAN topologies, wireless LAN flavors, and wireless LAN applications. A recap of OSI reference model. OSI reference model is a model that was created in back 50s. The purpose of this model is to make a standard for the operation of the devices. For example, before this model, the devices of the different vendor cannot communicate with each other. So that was the need that when scientists realized that we have a common point on which all the different vendor devices can communicate with each other. So they developed this model, which is called OSI reference model. It is still a reference model. Actual implemented model is TCP/IP model, which is still which is currently used. This model is only for the learning purpose. The basic purpose is for this model is to provide a layered architecture. Now, what is layered architecture? We will discuss a little bit later. Peer-to-peer process and encapsulation. So here is the layer architecture. In OSI reference model, there are total 7 layers. Layer 1, which is known as a physical layer. Layer 2, which is known as a data link layer. Layer 3, which is known as a network layer. Layer 4, which is known as a transport layer. Layer 3, which is known as a session layer. Layer 2, data layer. And layer 1, which is application layer. Now, when you want to send a message from computer A to computer B, for example, your message is, hello, this is Imran, how are you? Now, this message you will type on certain browser. That browser resides on application layer. This browser works on application layer. After writing of your message will be converted into binary format, and it will be represent its data by presentation layer, and it will be maintained by session layers. Session layer is responsible to maintain the session between sender and receiver. After that, data will be converted into segment by transport layer. As we already discussed, the transport layer is responsible for the reliable and unreliable communication, port addressing, error control, error detection, flow control, and error recovery. These all functions are performed by transport layer. After transport layer, it is further forwarded to the network layer. Now this packet is converted from segment to packet. Note here, from upper two layers, which are called host layers, and last three layers, which are called middle layers, when data is present on the upper layers, it is a data. When it is passed to the transport layer, it becomes a segment. When it passed on the network layer, it becomes a packet. When it passed on the data link layer, it becomes a frame, and frame can be transmitted on the physical layers. If we are talking about the hardwares, there are different types of hardware which are working on each layer. For example, on network layer, mostly your switches are working on network layer. Your routers are working on switches are working on data link layer. Your routers are working on network layer, and your firewall is working on transport layer. For peer-to-peer process, each layer, when communicate with another layer, it will provide additional information which is called header. For example, layer 7, which is known as the application layer, when it passes data to the presentation layer, it will add some sort of header. And what is header? It is a nothing but as additional information to secure the communication. After passing the data from layer 7, it will come to the layer 6. It will again add an header. Layer 5, it will again add an header. Layer 4, it will again add an header, and so on and so forth. Up to the layer 2, it also include header as well as trailer. that this processing of this adding this header to hide the data is called encapsulation. And this process will be reversed on the receiving side, which is called decapsulation. Now physical layer. We already discussed about the physical layer. Physical layer is responsible for the movements of the bits. Bits can be transmitted in the form of zeros and ones. When your original data reach at physical layers, it is in the form of frame. So basically on physical layer, frames are working in via a certain medium, and medium can be guided and unguided. We will discuss about the medium. Now medium can be classified as a guided medium and unguided medium. Guided medium color can be classified by twisted pair, coaxial cable, optical fiber, and unguided medium can be classified microwave, infrared, and others. Here others we can include radio waves, x-rays, and so on and so forth.